Today we're going to talk a little bit about intracranial hemorrhage. Before we begin, I've got to give some credit to some of my colleagues, Dr. Aiken and Dr. Hu, who provided many of the slides and concepts for this lecture. Our goals for this lecture are going to be to become familiar with the imaging appearance of intracranial hemorrhage, both on CT and MR. We're going to use some of our knowledge of hemorrhage to develop a systematic approach to looking at cases of hemorrhage. Then we'll apply it to some cases. We're going to focus on parenchymal hemorrhage. We're not going to talk that much about trauma or aneurysmal subarachnoid hemorrhage because they have their own distribution and appearance. There are many causes of hemorrhage. We're not going to cover all of them here, like hopefully you'll get an overview though. You'll get some idea of how you might differentiate some of these things. In general, aneurysm, vascular malformation, vasculitis, hypertension, these can all cause hemorrhage. The thing you'll probably see the most commonly just as you're working in the clinic is going to be hypertensive hemorrhage or aneurysmal hemorrhage. When you have younger patients, drug use is very commonly at play. When you see more focal or multifocal areas of hemorrhage, you've got to think about other focal lesions like tumors, metastases, cavernomas, trauma, and a number of other conditions. To get this out of the way, like I said, we're not going to talk about aneurysmal or traumatic hemorrhage very much. Aneurysmal hemorrhage is mostly subarachnoid hemorrhage. You can sometimes get associated intraparenchymal hemorrhage, particularly in the inferior frontal lobes. You'll often have acute onset symptoms. You'll have syncope. You'll have headache. Worst headache of life is the classic distribution. Those hemorrhages tend to go on to CT angiogram or angiography, and they tend to get imaged less, or once the finding is known, you don't really, it's not that much of a diagnostic dilemma. Traumatic hemorrhage is kind of similar in the sense that you often have a history of trauma. So you typically know that there was a car accident, a car hit a pedestrian or something like that. Traumatic hemorrhage doesn't really follow a lot of rules. It can be subarachnoid, subdural, epidural, it can kind of be all over the place. But that's going to be the extent to which I'm going to cover these topics here today. Before we move on, I just want to show you this one interlude a little while back. If you started typing in Google, radiologists are, these were the kind of things that you get as your autocomplete. The most interesting one, I think, is this radiologists are parasites here. Radiologists are not doctors, so I think that you'll kind of see what people are typing into Google. So that's a little bit interesting.